substitution with freshman Aaliyah Patty checking in, a 6'3 freshman from Lombard, Illinois, suburb of Chicago, had 12 points, 5 boards in the exhibition win against IUP. Patty's got it out front, Buckeye ball down 9-5. Give for Grande at the right wing. Now for Crooms between the circles. Starts to drive. Goes to the lane. Floats it up. And no good. Tip wouldn't go. Vaughted around. Waterman's got it. Powers for the ball and got fouled. Waterman, who hustles on the offensive glass. And that's been a staple from day one for her. She draws a foul on Shea Levert, her first.
How about this second effort and the persistency by Michaela Waterman on the boards? That was outstanding.
Buckeye ball on the baseline. Lob in goes now for Patty. Foul line. Patty with a 1-4 set. Hands off for Grande at the right elbow. Now to Crooms at the right point. Dribbles off to the left point. Leaves now for Santoro. Comes to the corner. Throws for Waterman. 4-3. It's no good. It was online, but it was a little bit long. And the rebound comes down to Laksa of USF. Bulls right to left. 6 minutes gone. Opening quarter, 9-5. They lead the opener here in Columbus. Return of a home at home from a year ago. Buckeyes met him down there in February in sunny Tampa. Laksa at the top of the circle. Circles down the lane left side. Runs into a defender. Got fouled. Missed the shot. Free throws coming up. The foul is going to be called on Janae Crooms. That'll be her first. The fifth on the Buckeyes, putting USF in the penalty here.
Well, two little challenges for the Buckeyes. And again, we were just talking about it coming in off the screens. But the other piece of that is the on-ball defender has to do a better job staying with the ball. But the help side needs to be rotating over. They're a little late. They're allowing a gap and a seam for South Florida to be able to get to the rim. And Ohio State has to have better help coming over and hedging.
Locks of the two-time honorable mention All-American performer circles that free throw through her first point of the game. By this point a year ago in the game down in Tampa, she had about 21 already on 6 or 7 triples. She went off on the Buckeyes for 8 total threes and 15 field goals with a career-high 41 in that game. She makes both free throws. By the way, last year she was a 97% free throw shooter that led America. She hits both of them. It's 11-5 USF. They have run 11 of the last 14 points, and the Buckeyes turned it over again out front with Patty driving to the foul line, and she took steps.
Now, that's just a matter of reading the defense a little bit sooner and better. You get down that deep, you have to make sure that you back yourself out. You can't commit yourself, but you need to do a better job of reading the defenders.
A fourth Buckeye turnover gives it back to the Bulls. They have a 6-point lead and controlled it from right to left. Harvey down the midline, works to the right of the lane, drives the baseline, and they're going to get a foul called on the drive.
That's just a
foul on Carmen Grande.
Yes.
Second foul.
Yep.
She
got caught standing up. And that's where you have to make sure that you stay down. Because once you start to stand up, you allow that offensive player to be able to turn the corner.
Penalty in effect to our left. Harvey's first free throw in and out. No good. Harvey, a freshman from Nashville. Ohio State in foul trouble here. And they're not overly deep. Naja Quinlan is going to check in for the first time, a 5'10 graduate student transfer from Pacific. She's out of Sacramento. She sat out last year. Second free throw good. Two fouls on Grande, two fouls on Miller. That free throw goes in for Harvey, her third point. And it's 12-5. USF has the lead. Buckeye ball at the right wing. Crooms throws it out front for Quinlan, who gives it over to the left wing for Santoro. And on the drive, she's bodied and bumped. Blocking foul going to be called, I think. Did they get Raider? Yes, Melissa Raider's first. And the second on the Bulls, they're going to get a substitution. Tamara Henshaw, a junior from Palm Coast, Florida, in for Raider.
Oh, nice job by Santoro. Once the ball got reversed, she put the ball on the floor. She was able to turn the corner on the defender.
Ohio State fresh shot clock, side left inbounds, trailing 12-5. Buckeyes have been just one of their last 7 from the floor. Quinlan at the foul line, leaves for Santoro, back top of the key. Santoro starts in, jump stop at the left block, throws it across to the left corner, Quinlan. No shot there. Juhas left wing, she's open, fires a 3 and missed it short, no good. Rebound, Ferreira of USF. Ferreira right to left in forecourt, on the drive and around a screen, got bodied and fouled. Ohio State, all sorts of fouling here. The foul's going to go on Janae Crooms, her second.
Well, Crooms fell into the trap. She took the bait. Little hesitation in an in-and-out dribble. And Crooms stood up and took the initial fake.
Ohio State just 2 out of 9 from the Florida Open. USF 4 of 12, but they're going to live at the line here in the remaining part of the first quarter. In the final 3 minutes, Laura Ferreira, the fifth-year senior from Portugal, hits the first free throw. Grande for Crooms for Ohio State. Bulls will sub. And Elisa Penzan checks in. She is a freshman guard from Italy. Second free throw missed for Ferreira, and the rebound to Ohio State's Carmen Grande. 13-5, the USF lead. 6-0 run for the Bulls to grab this 8-point lead. 2:40 left first quarter. Santoro pitches right corner to Juhas, angles to the foul line, gives it back to Santoro at the corner. She'll drive to the baseline, force the shot up, miss it. Rebound, Quinlan couldn't handle it. Instead, Shea Leverett comes away with it for the Bulls. 2:29 left in the first quarter. 7-0 run, USF. Guard Ferreira looks back to Coach Jose Fernandez for the play call. Now Loxa on the right wing, far side for the Bulls. Top of the key for Shea Leverett. Reverses to Penzan at the left wing. Back on top, it'll come for Ferreira with 8 to shoot. Santoro's got her in the man defense. Spin move, Ferreira. Foul line, turnaround jumper, missed it. Foul caught, Ohio State. It has been a foul fest. That's on Santoro, her first. That is the 9th Ohio State foul in this first quarter. There's still 2 minutes left in the quarter. 13-5, the USF lead.
Now, Ohio State just seems to be not quite ready for the amount of movement that South Florida has within their offense. But if you look at the difference in the screens for South Florida is literally, when they're coming off of a screen, they're totally utilizing the screen and coming off shoulder to shoulder, which is causing problems for Ohio State. On the offensive end for Ohio State, there's a lot of room, and South Florida is able to get right through the screen. So Ohio State on the offensive end is not able to open things up as much. That's why you've got a little bit more one-on-one for Ohio State on the offensive end.
Ferreira bags the first free throw. She's at 2 of 3 from the line. She was 77% for the stripe a year ago, and that free throw is good. It's her third point. USF has opened the lead to 10. 15-5 Bulls with 2:04 to play in the first quarter. Ohio State's Grande into forecourt at the left wing for Miller, who's back in with 2 fouls. Ball on the right wing for Juhas. Dorco drive baseline, fling one up from 12 feet, and it rolls and goes in for Dorca Juhas, who has 4 of the Buckeyes, 7.
Now she did a nice job pulling up for the jumper right there in the short corner.
Juhas, the freshman from Pécs, Hungary. 15-7, the Bulls lead with 1:39 to play in the opening quarter. Ferreira at the top of the key, forecourt to our left for USF. Hands off for Loxa, flips the 3 up and knocked it down. Santoro had a hand up, but not close enough. And Loxa, who last year hit 126 triples, bags her first of this year. She has 5, and it's 18-7 USF. This 11-point lead, their largest lead. Buckeye ball, and on the drive at the right of the key, Waterman. She'll take it in at the low right and get bodied and fouled. Missed a shot from the baseline right, but got fouled by... for the stripe a year ago for a Buckeye team that a season ago shot it at 74%. First one for the grad student Waterman. She rattles it down, a 6'2 forward from Kettering, Ohio, in Fairmont High School. Degree in psychology. Second free throw. That one rolls off the front iron, no good, but we're going to get a lane violation on USF. Called on Henshaw to give Waterman another throw. 1:19 to play, first quarter from the shot. It's 18-8, Bulls the lead over the Buckeyes. Waterman with the second free throw try again, missed it again. So same result. Rebound comes down to Ferreira of USF. She'll draw into front court, throw it out front. It's a miscommunication, but the ball is saved by Ferreira. Penzan with a touch between the keys. Leaves at the high right for you, for Loxa. Guarded by Juhas. Top of the key for Penzan, and she'll fling in a 3 and a fist pump to boot. Penzan's first triple of the game. First points collegiately. 21-8. Bulls have the lead. The run is 21-6. 50 seconds left to play in the opening quarter. Juhas leaves right wing Santoro, who angles to the foul line. Now for Grande for a left wing 3. Knocked it down to the Buckeyes. Carmen Grande's first points as a Buckeye.
Now, nice job spotting up by Grande.
26 triples a year ago for Grande. Gets that one there, and we'll get a turnover on the Bulls in front court at the foul line. Henshaw took an extra step, and the giveaway, the third turnover for USF here tonight.
Well, let's just see if Ohio State can capitalize on this. This is an opportunity. See if they can take advantage.
21-11, trying to get it to single digits. 30 on the first quarter clock, 4 less on the shot clock. It's The Bulls set up in a man defense, waiting on Grande, who backs towards center circle. That beautiful new floor here at the Value City Arena. 10 to shoot. Grande starts to the left. 14 on the first quarter clock. Grande to the drive at the baseline. Throws it across. Waterman open. Right point three up. Waterman got dipped to the floor. No called. She faded away and threw an air ball out of bounds. And the ball will go over to USF with 7 4/10 remaining in the opening quarter.
Now, she can knock those down. I don't necessarily have a problem with that. She was wide open. She just didn't knock the shot down. But she's a good enough shooter from there.
Henshaw and Menzon go to the bench. Inbounds comes up the floor for Lox across the line. 4 seconds left. Lox a long three, head of the circle. No good. 2 seconds left. Juhas goes flying in for the rebound, but Rader gets it and sticks it up from the left side and missed. And that's the end of the first quarter.
It's up a little bit more by utilizing their teammates.
Buckeyes have Grande, Crooms, and Miller each with 2 fouls, and we'll catch the Ohio State lineup here on the fly. Bulls have the ball to open the second quarter, and they've got Harvey running the point. She weaves off to the right wing far side in front of the Buckeye bench, comes back out between the rings. USF working forecourt to our left here in the first half. Harvey on the crossover and the drive, and a scoop layup try good from the low left. And we're going to get a bucket and one, and then a whistle and a foul on the Bulls. Harvey with the lay-in has 5.
It's going to be after the play. Well, there might be some question on that.
Jordow got her first foul called there, Beatrice Jordow, and that's the first of the second quarter. Then Jesse Dickerson he didn't go to the monitor. I think they maybe reset the clock.
Well,
or was there a warning issue?
I think the foul happened after the shot. So my guess is whether or not the shot counted where the foul was.
23-11 the count. Bulls have the lead. Left wing three. Miller, it's short, no good. It glances barely off the iron. Quick trigger there for Adriana Miller of Ohio State. Rader the rebound. Bulls the ball. Rader out front. Works left. Leaves for Harvey. Wide open to the left wing. Doesn't shoot. Drives instead. Draws contact. And she caught a jump ball. And the ball will go to Ohio State. I didn't see her tie it up, but an alternating arrow will give it to the Buckeyes. Good defense there by Carmen Grande. Yes, Grande runs the point. Waterman's on the floor as well, along with Crooms, Miller, and Malia Patty, who handles at the foul line. And down drives down the lane and scoops it up and missed with the right hand. Rebound comes off to Loxa. Kitty Loxa, 2-time honorable mention All-America, traveled, working up the right sideline in front of Coach McGuff and the Buckeye bench. Ball back to Ohio State.
Well, nice job by the Buckeyes getting back and at least stopping the ball. South Florida trying to come back and get the person that was trailing, but Ohio State doing a nice job with the on-ball defense.
Grande will work it into front court with a minute gone of the second quarter. 23-11. The Bulls have the lead. The Buckeyes the rock. Ohio State has it out front with Patty. Patty gives for Grande and back to Patty at the high right. Dribbles off to the right of the key. Down the lane of the right block with a left hand. Laid it up, missed it. She drove in from the right but used the offhand, and the rebound comes down to Jordow of USF.
Well, that was a tough shot right there, but she did a nice job creating. And then, as you said, Matt, coming back with that left hand to try and get a better angle at the basket.
Locks a right wing freeze, wide open three, bullseye. You cannot leave her open. Timeout, Ohio State's Kevin McGuff. As Loxa hits her second triple and has 8 points in the game. And we'll get our second call, Grande, Waterman, and Miller. Half-court man defense by USF as Grande walks it up left to right and gets it into the front court. Grande for Waterman at the right wing at the arc. Top of the key for Ohio State's Patty. And now back out front for Santoro. At the left wing for Miller, who weaves across the top of the circle and now moves foul line. Throws it left wing Waterman. Shot fake. One dribble out left point Santoro. 10 to shoot. Back to Waterman out front. Sets, fires a three. Waterman rolls off, no good. Rebound comes down to Jordow. Beatrice Jordow the board. And now the outlet up the right wing into the front court. It's Harvey. A little friendly wager we'll discuss here during the next dead ball. At the right wing, it's Loxa. Kitty Loxa feeds inside. Ball deflected away into the hands, though, of Jordow. And Beatrice will turn around and flip it in as 9 points.
Ohio State just a little out of position because they should have been in position to be able to come up with that loose ball. Instead, they paid.
Beatrice has 9. Freshman from Portugal. We heard a lot about her coming in, and she's lived up to it in her debut. Freshman, Waterman spins. Nice reverse pivot. Missed the layup try. Middle of the lane. Short shot comes off to USF. Bulls have it, and working into front court, Sidney Harvey. You think by the end of the year, Waterman will lead this team in three-point shots?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Nope, not at all. Fox ahead of the wheel, 15 to shoot, 28-11 USF. Three-point shot fading away at the top, won't go. Rebound out of bounds. It was untouched. It'll go to the Buckeyes with 7:06 to play in the first half. USF led 21-11 after one quarter. They've scored the first seven of the second period.
Well, Matt, Ohio State struggling from the floor, 22%. South Florida, 45%.
Dorky Juhas back in, replacing Aaliyah Patty. Juhas has it at the top. Dribble drive down the lane. Scoops it up and scored with the left hand of the tape. Dorky Juhas. You're going to like her, folks. I can promise you that. She has six.
Well, she's going to town a little bit right there. Putting the ball on the floor. Getting right to the rim.
Harvey trying to feed for the right wing at the right post. Ball was intended for Jordan. It was kicked out of bounds. 24 on the shot clock. It'll hold right there. 28-13 the count. Bulls lead the Buckeyes. 6:40 to play first half. And a baseline right inbound situation for Harvey.
Matt, Ohio State's settling for some threes. They're 2 of 10 from the three-point line.
Harvey will get it in. Baseline right. Locks it. Drives the baseline. Double teams taken away. Miller a steal to Ohio State. Check that. Quinlan the steal. Naja Quinlan. She'll give it off for Grande at the left wing. Gallops to the left baseline. Now drives the baseline. Gets free and missed a layup for the right hand from left to the rim. And the rebound a Raider of USF. An easy bunny there that they couldn't get to fall. Outlet Ferreira, left wing, starts in, hand check foul. Carly Santoro reaching in, that'll be her second, and that's Talia, team foul number one of the Buckeyes in the second quarter.
Now, Ohio State playing that first step very tightly, and what's happening is they're getting caught, and that's where if they just give a little bit, another half of an arm length, they'd be able to defend that first step a little bit better.
USF with the ball up 28-13, 6:20 to play in the first half. Pulls the ball to the right wing. Ferreira looks to enter. Does the low right for Raider. Backs down. Waterman had traveled, and she threw the off arm. Jesse was going to call a walk, but instead player control foul on Raider, who barreled that shoulder down, and that's her second foul.
Now, that was a great job by Waterman by keeping her good, nice defensive positioning. She didn't reach, didn't lean in, and she held her ground.
Carmen Grande for Ohio State controls in front court. Top of the circle, Waterman. Michaela directing traffic, leaves back for Grande, who weaves down the key right side, right-hand layup this time, won't go. She took it all the way to the rack. Rebound comes off to USF, and flying up the floor, Harvey feeds underneath, and Jordal's layup try scooping with the left is blocked out of bounds. I think Waterman got it, and will stay with the Bulls. 25 to shoot.
Well, Grande's getting down inside the paint, but you have the length of South Florida that is causing some problems with Grande being able to get that shot off. A lot of deflections right now for USF.
24% Ohio State shooting here in the first half. Bulls at 43%. They lead by 15. With under six to play in the half. 25 on the Bulls shot clock. Baseline left. Ferreira gets it in. Left wing for Kitty Alaksa. Now to the top, Ferreira. Ferreira leaves right point for Harvey in front of the Ohio State bench. One dribble. Set back three. Harvey rimmed out. No good. Dorky Juhas the rebound for the Bucks. Hands it off for Grande. Carmen with her right hand dribbled and now switches hands on the dribble into forecourt. At the right point off the Waterman screen, rolls down the key left side, throws across, Juhas for three. No good, another three missed. Rebound though, Ohio State's Grande. Top of the key for Santoro, who steps into a three. No good. Rebound tipped and out of bounds off the Bulls. Good hustle by Quinlan to knock it off of Harvey, and it'll stay with Ohio State as the Buckeyes now are 2 of 12 from distance.
Now, nice job there by the Buckeyes keeping the ball alive. The issue with your big players taking the three-point shot is now it limits your rebounding opportunities.
Juhas, a beautiful baseline drive, missed a layup from the left. Rebound, though, Quinlan, Ohio State, and stuck it back in left of the rim. Naja Quinlan's first points as a Buckeye.
A nice little follow-up and pickup there by Quinlan.
28-15 Bulls, midpoint, second quarter. Here from the Value City Arena in Columbus. Tony Resch, I'm Matt Anders. We'll get a traveling call as Loxa caught the ball to the left wing and took steps, turning it over. She says something to Waterman. Waterman didn't care for it much. Gives the ball
back to that previous play there. Michaela Waterman actually forced that turnover because she edged on the pick on the ball. And that's exactly what you need to do.
Buckeyes the ball, top of the key, Waterman, 28-15, USF the lead. Waterman throws for Juhas, an errant pass that she runs down, gives to Quinlan, who goes to the lane, throws it across, and it's tipped out of bounds by Harvey to the Bulls bench and into the stands. The Bucks will retain with 16 on the shot clock and 4:44 on the second quarter timer. 28-15 USF. Queenland will inbound left sideline. The transfer grad student from Pacific. She's got it out front. She gives back now for Grande, who starts down the lane right side. Scoops it up. No good. Another layup missed that time by Carmen Grande. Rebound Ferreira, USF. Her outlet goes up the right sideline for Harvey. Sydney Harvey for the Bulls. Checked by Grande and the man. Comes back between the circles. Sets up by that Buckeye Blocko. It's Ohio State in black, the Blocko in scarlet. And the underlying imprint of the state of Ohio right in midcourt. On the drive, Harvey in from the left. Missed the layup try, but got hacked on the arm as she put it up. Fouled. Free throws coming up. The Waterman foul will be her second.
Now, Waterman came over to help, but she got her on the hand on the way up, a little bit on the arm. Matt, the Buckeyes still struggling from the floor, 23%, 6 of 26, and from the three-point line, 17%, 2 of 12.
Bulls are 7 of 9 at the stripe, all in the first quarter, and two throws coming here for Sydney Harvey to our left, and that first one is in. Freshman from Nashville has 6. Aaliyah Patty back in for Ohio State. Janae Croom's in as well. Waterman to the bench along with Grande. The Bulls make a substitution. Beatrice sets down. And they'll get Shea Leverett back in.
Now, Matt, there's a little discrepancy on the boards here. Ohio State getting out rebounded 24-11.
Harvey hit the second free throw and has 7. And now USF doubling up the Bucks 30-15. On the drive, stepping under with a Euro step. Janae Cruz missed a layup in the low right, tipped out of bounds. See, this is going to be the issue. You can't miss layups when you're trying to struggling to score, as Ohio State is. And this figures to be a team offensively that will struggle to score after the Scarlet and Gray put up 85 points per game a year ago.
Well, and that's why you can't settle from the three-point line. Either that or you need to do a much better job on the offensive glass.
Harvey for USF controlling in forecourt. Gives now out front for Henshaw, who steps in, drives to the left block, missed the layup try. Strong off the glass. Rebound Dorka Juhas, who runs it into front court for the Buckeyes. Now for the trailer. Out front, it's Grooms. Grooms drops it inside. Aaliyah Patty from the low right, her first collegiate points.
It's just great execution there out of transition, but you've got to love it when your big comes down with the ball and starts the break.
No question. 30-17. We'll get a driving layup try by Harvey. She missed. She got pushed from behind. The foul on Janae Crooms. Her third. And that'll bring Carmen Grande right off the bench. And more free throws coming up for USF. The Bulls in their 47th season of women's hoops have been to the NCAA tournament 4 straight times, returning 7 ladder winners, 6 true freshmen on this squad. Coach Jose Fernandez has done a great job there. Free throw number 1 up and in for Harvey. Here's the deal with USF. There's no pressure for them to win the league. They're in UConn's conference, the American. The Buckeyes will see them Sunday, so you're not supposed to be first in that league. Jose can finish second in the conference year in and year out, and they're going to go to the tournament and be a threat.
Yep. However, he was coach of the year last year.
Well, he was, and to your point, 4 of their 8 losses came 3 to UConn and 1 to the national champion Notre Dame. 32-17, Bulls the lead with 3:25 left first half, and Ohio State the ball. 9 for Harvey as she hit both free throws a moment ago. Miller at the point. Now out front it'll come for Dorka. Juhas on the dribble. Down the key. Flipped away and stolen. Had it knocked away from behind by Leverett. Bulls Ferreira transitions back. Forecourt left. Drives. Steps through. Throws it out front. Trailing Potanza, who just checked into the game for the first time. Inside on the drive at the low left. Harvey had it knocked away. Scrum on the floor. Taken away by Ohio State's Dorka Juhas. Outlet comes up the left wing for Santoro. Buckeyes the ball down 15. Santoro angles of the paint, goes to the bucket, scooped it in and scored with a right-hand runner.
Now, once again, you have your post player that starts the break. Dorka's really showing how she can handle the ball. She's down low, ball's down low, she's pushing the ball, and that allowed your guards to get up the floor much quicker.
Santoro has 5, the 32-19. 32-19 lead, USF. 2.5 left opening half. Harvey on the dribble drive off the pick. Throws it across to the corner for an open 3. That one's misfired, but hits it. And we're going to get a rebound foul on USF.
Now, nice inside positioning there by the Buckeyes. Patty doing a nice job as well as Santoro. Excuse me, Grande on the inside position there.
Oh, Jenna Cross signaled foul on USF. They change it to a foul on Carmen Grande.
Oh, no way.
Her third foul. 2:24 to go in the first half, and Buckeyes in all sorts of foul trouble, and add another one to it. On the feet inside, Patty fouls on the turnaround hook shot. Patty's first. 15th foul of the Buckeyes. Almost in effect. Free throw line left. Shane Leverett, the sophomore from Rincon, Georgia. Well, we're going to give it a few games before we deem the fouling a problem in terms of a trend, but it has been a problem here in the first half. Rincon. Leverett, line left, bags the first free throw. Waterman in for Grande, who has the three fouls. 2:22 to go in the half. The Bulls lead 33-19.
The learning curve is, you know, the Buckeyes need to tighten things up defensively. They're leaving too much of a lane. Adjustments that they'll be looking at halftime, and certainly that they'll be addressing in practice.
Leverett hit both free throws. USF leads by 15, Tony, yet they don't have a field goal in 5.5 minutes. 34-19, the Bulls the lead over the Buckeyes. 2:12 to play, first half. Left wing, it's Miller, Ohio State. Gets a matchup zone, it looks like, out front for Waterman. Waterman stops, drops it off at the baseline, and on the drive, out of bounds, a turnover. Patty tried the baseline drive and couldn't handle it, and the ball to go back to the Bulls.
Now, that was because USF doubled down on the ball, right on the block. Looking to trap out of it. They will do that. They trap on the corners when they can.
Pinzon at the point, out front for Panhadzic. Panhadzic plays it off on the left wing for Laksa. Kitty Laksa at the foul line, crosses over, takes Juhas, fades left of the key, 10-footer, no good. Pretty good defense by Dorka Juhas. And another Buckeye foul called on the rebound. That's going to go on Santoro, her third. Grande with three, Crooms with three, Santoro with three, Miller with two, Waterman with two. 14 fouls on the Buckeyes. Still 1:40 to play in the first half.
Well, Matt, again, it just goes back to positioning. You know, Ohio State not sitting down, not getting the reverse pivots. When you forward pivot on your box out, you're going to miss the player, and you're always coming in from behind. You get the reverse pivot, you'll have the positioning, you'll be able to get your opponent on the reach.
Miller Leverett hit the first free throw. Miller's going to replace Santoro for the Buckeyes. 35-19, the Bulls have the lead. And again, USF expanding this lead from the foul line as that second free throw is missed. But despite going 6 minutes plus now without a field goal. Miller for Ohio State has the ball in front court to Dorka Juhas out top of the key. Now she'll play it off for the freshman Patty, who gives back for Miller. Miller weaving at the left wing far side. Top of the key, Patty, reverse for Juhas. Steps into a long three, top of the key, no good off the heel of the rim. And the rebound is returned by Leverett of USF. Quick outlet up the floor, left wing Laksa. Thought about the 3 minute 12 to play in the half. Laksa on the drive, throws it across to the corner. But Hadzic with a touch out to the right wing. Timeout called by USF head coach Jose Fernandez using his first half 30. 60. Kitty Laksa will inbound right at the hash mark. And I really like the sidelines of this new floor. You've got some scarlet, some gray, some white, some black.
Oh, it's a beautiful floor.
Brand new, year one here in the Value City Arena. This is the 21st year of this building. Inbounds out front for Laksa. 13 to shoot. 1 minute left first half. Bulls lead by 16. Laksa works to the top left. Leaves it back between the rings for Pinzon. Pinzon steps off a screen, top of the circle, three-point shot short, rebound stuck up and in by Henshaw left of the rim.
Ohio State going underneath the screen initially, and then off the air ball, you've got USF in position there.
Scoring drought was 7 minutes, and they get a layup try. The Buckeyes miss a three out front. Patty board balls it. Rebound comes off to Pinzon. 37-19, USF. They have led all but the first 2 points. 25 seconds left in the half. 16 on the shot clock. Pinzon plays for Laksa at the right wing. Passes out front for Henshaw. 10 to shoot. Three at the top. Laksa, no good. Hit the top of the backboard and the shot clock and out of bounds. Well, they've not let Laksa beat them, that's for sure. The supporting cast has been very good. Laksa with 8 points. 2 of 10 shooting. And 2 of 6 on threes. Miller out, Santoro in with a shot clock off and 14 seconds left. Buckeyes have scored just 8 second quarter points. 16 for the visitors from Tampa. Grande picks up the inbounds pass as it rolls near midcourt. She'll come to the top of the key with 10. Veers off to the left now with 8. on the stutter step out to Santoro, who traveled at the left point with 4 seconds left. Turnover number 7 on Ohio State. Actually, USF with 8 now. Ball to go back to the Bulls with 4.6 seconds left in the half.
Now, Kevin trying to make the substitution to avoid any fouls being picked up by Santoro and Grande.
The inbounds at backcourt at the side right for Henshaw in front of the Bulls bench. Henshaw looks to get it in for Harvey. Instead, plays it straight away for Ferreira. 3 seconds, right point three up, and no good. 1-0, and the horn. We've come to the half here at the Value City Arena. The school, you too.
Always remember, you never believe what you hear.
USF with the ball to begin the second half. Moving left to right, they've got it with Harvey at the point. Top of the key for Loxa. Bulls have the possession to start the third quarter. Loxa feeds it the little right, and Beatrice traveled. She didn't agree with the call, turning it over. Buckeyes right to left with Waterman, Grande, Juhas, Santoro, and I think Miller. It is. And on the drive, Grande goes in for the little right, threw it over the bottom of the backboard. But the rebound comes down to Waterman, and she shuffled her feet at the right block and traveled, turning it right back over.
Well, you know what? I don't so much have a problem with that. You attack the glass, then you try and get that offensive board. That was a great job there. Unfortunately, as Waterman was trying to split the defenders, she traveled, but at least they're being aggressive.
Harvey into front court for the Bulls. Throws it out front. On the drive, right of the key, Loxa fades, fires, missed a 10-footer. Rebound foul on USF. Grande hit the deck along with Ferreira, and they get that on Ferreira.
Yep, the Buckeyes doing a much better job of getting an inside position and getting a clean box out.
37-19, USF with the lead. Buckeyes the ball right to left. Grande leaves for Santoro, top of the key. Man defense, USF. Ball right wing for Grande. Swings for Waterman at the right corner. Loops a pass on top. Grande gives for Santoro. She curls right of the elbow and now hands off for Waterman. Waterman to the foul line and now out front for Grande on the drive. Flips it up. Missed it low on the right. Rebound, Juhas throws it back out. Deflected away. 5 to shoot. Miller handles out front. Adriana Miller on the drive. Bailed out with 2 to shoot. Fouled. Trip to the floor, and it'll be a floor foul. Foul's going to go on Ferreira, her second of the quarter.
Well, here's the thing. What I like about that is the fact that she put the ball on the floor to try and get to the rim.
And a fresh shot clock now for the Buckeyes. Ball loop to Juhas. Dorca leaves for Waterman, left elbow. Now to the curling Grande. Shot fake. Over to Dorca. Juhas baseline drive. Throws back across to Miller with the left wing. Left corner for Santoro. Not a clean pass. Couldn't get the shot off. Top of the key, Waterman. 16 to shoot. Nearly walked to the left wing. Fades to the left corner for Miller. Baseline drive, left block. Scooped it up with the right hand. Missed it. Dorkett got the board. Missed it on the putback. It hit the bottom of the cylinder, but we're getting a whistle and a foul on USF. That's going to go on Beatrice, her second. 2 free throws. Dorkett, Juhas to our left.
Well, Juhas did a nice job of going up to get the ball instead of going over the back. USF had the inside position, didn't get a great clean box out, but Dorcas stayed straight up and was able to at least draw the foul. She did a nice job of not fouling herself.
That free throw rims off. Juhas, who played on multiple Hungarian national teams since 2015, the 12th ranked international player in last year's class and a top 5 forward, hit that free throw, her 7th point. 37-20 USF. 90 seconds gone, third quarter. Bulls the ball. Fourth court right down below us. Moving left to right here in the third quarter in the second half. And it's Harvey on the drive from the top of the key down to the little right. She got fouled on the drive and the layup miss. Now it's going to go on Waterman, but that's her third. First of the third quarter on Ohio State.
Yeah, that's the problem. When that offensive player is able to turn the corner at that point, then defensively you're chasing. And then if there's any contact that's made, 95% of the time you're going to get called for that foul.
Harvey bags the first free throw, her 10th point. She is 6 of 7 from the line in the game, and this one for her 11th point of the night. It's in. Sydney Harvey, freshman from Brentwood Academy High School in Nashville. 39-20, the USF lead with 8:20 to play in the third. Grande controls out front, leaves for Dorca, gives it back to Grande, hands for Waterman at the right wing. Right corner will go for Grande on the spin to the lane. Pitch across, tipped out of bounds. Pass for Santoro at the near corner, but deflected away nicely by Ferreira. 14 to shoot, Buckeyes retain. And they're going to get Janae Cruz into the game, replacing Grande.
Now, Kevin utilizing a deep bench.
left sideline, will inbound, gets it out front, handled there by Crooms with 10 to shoot off the curl to the foul line out front. Waterman puts it down, back to Crooms, 5 to shoot, barrels into the lane, flipped the shot up, missed it, ball tipped around and taken by Loxa, run out left to right, Loxa one-on-one, pulls up from 12, line drive to short, rebound comes down to Ohio State's Janae Crooms, she'll move back right to left, fumble the ball away at the top of the key and turned it over, ball taken away by Raider, who nearly walked, gets it in front court, and then Miller reaches in and commits a foul 40 feet away. Raider controlled, brought it up, nearly lost it. Miller won the ball and commits her third foul. And who is not in foul trouble right now for Ohio State? Queenland's not. She checks in. Miller goes out with three fouls.
Hey, I'm not real sure what she was trying to do in that situation.
7:41 left in the third. Bulls have the ball and a lead. 39-20 USF. Harvey at the point, to the left wing, steps back, fires and bags a three on a nice dribble drive pickup. Harvey with 14, a good-looking freshman from Nashville.
Well, she takes advantage of just being able to have a step, and that's all you need is just a little bit to make some separation.
Dorka right wing tries to answer her three, strong, no good, glances off the rim. 42-20, Bulls up 22, large lead, wanting more. Harvey all the way with a scoop shot, right-hand lay-in. She has 16-7 this half. 3 minutes gone, third quarter, Bulls running away, and Kevin McGuff's going to call time. Toss. Buckeye ball, forecourt left. Inbounds comes for Janae Crooms. Crooms, a freshman from Cranston, Rhode Island. Right wing Santoro, now for Waterman, right point. Bounce pass, top of the key for Crooms. Crooms off the pick to Dork ahead of the wheel. Squares up, leaves it off left wing for Queenland. 12 to shoot. Naja Queenland hands off Crooms. Sidorka Juhas at the left wing. Drives at the baseline. Finds Waterman. Free low on the right. Missed the shot. Foul called on the recovery by Harvey. A late swat from behind. Waterman will have to earn it from the line. Two free throws.
Nice little dump off there. Juhas was able to draw two defenders. Waterman got in a gap. How about the handles from Juhas?
Mm-hmm. Freshman looking impressive here in her debut as Waterman misses the first free throw to our left. Mikhail, of course, last year battled a high left ankle sprain, also had her neck strain and that scary injury at Wisconsin. Second free throw, Waterman up and in, her second point of the game. She played in 32 games last year and averaged 3.5 points, 4 rebounds. 44-21, the Bulls have the lead. Ohio State had 11 at the end of one quarter. So the next 14 and a half minutes or so, they've settled for 10 points. Bulls have it, running the lane right side. Loxa with a running right-hander, good from 10 feet. Kitty Loxa. 10 for Loxa.
Yeah, just great touch around the rim.
46-21, USF, 6:14 to play in the third. Scoop shot, Crooms scores, moving in from the left with a scoop right-hand lay-in. Her first points as a Buckeye.
Yep, she set that up, a little hesitation. Came back to the left side, but finished with the right hand.
Six to play in the third. 46-23 USF on the drive. Harvey, hand check, foul called. Janae Crooms, her fourth. That's a third of the third quarter on Ohio State. Crooms will go out. Carmen Grande back in. The grad transfer from Madrid, Spain, and a transfer from Ball State University. Fresh shot clock for the Bulls. Baseline left. Inbound triggered into the left corner for Loxa. And Loxa lost it out of bounds. Jose Fernandez losing his mind right now. Thought that ball was either tipped out or a foul. Did not get the call from Jesse Dickerson. Protests again. Loxa can't believe the call. And the Buckeyes will get it. So a turnover for USF. Grande controls, moving right to left for Ohio State. Bounces for Carly Santoro, left wing. Gives for Juhas. Dorcas. Dorka at the top, and now the drive to the low right. Puts it up. Spins the iron. It scores. Bucket and one for Dorka Juhas on the take to the top to the right.
And I'll tell you right now, Matt, you know, Ohio State's starting to use her a little bit more on some dribble penetration, but also you've got to look at trying to feed her on the inside. Let her post up a little bit. Give her the ball on the low block, because now you're looking at some three-point opportunities. You know, in the first half, Ohio State was totally settling for the three-point shots, only 13%, 2 of 15 from the three-point line, and Ohio State really doesn't have the three-point shooters. Give her the block, give her the ball on the block and let her go to work.
Well, that time she got it out front and created on the drive.
Absolutely.
The score and the
yes.
And one. The free throw gives her 10. 46-26, Dorca in double figures in her first collegiate game. Tony mentions the Buckeyes have just 2 threes. Last year averaged nearly 9 a game. And on the take, around UHAS, Raider to the low left with a ball fake. Put it up, missed it, but got fouled. And Dorca called for the foul, and Raider to the line for 2 throws.
Well, now South Florida comes back, and they try to take it right at Dorca. Dorca got that done at the other end. All of a sudden, they try to return the favor.
Alyssa Raider, a junior from Thornton, Colorado, transferred via Northern Arizona, hits the first free throw. Played her freshman year in Northern Arizona. Last year, 6.6 rebounds for USF. She missed the second free throw. 47-26 is the score in favor of USF. Raider missing both of those free throws. Santoro with the ball out front for Ohio State on the drive to the low left. Scoops it up and in with the right hand for the left angle drive. Carly Santoro with 7.
Nice little hesitation. Got the defender to commit, and then she came back with that inside hand on the finish.
47-28 Bulls, midpoint third quarter. USF with the ball, left wing open, 3 by Ferreira, up and in front of the USF bench. Ferreira knocked it down cold-blooded. Hit 45 threes a year ago, that's her first triple tonight. 50-28 USF. Grande out front for Dorca, puts it down, plays for Santoro, top of the key, on the drive, down the key right side, scoops it up and score with the right hand again. Carly Santoro has 9.
A nice little curl to the basket. Did a great job coming off the pick. Nice job getting to the rim.
50-30 USF. 4.5 minutes left third quarter from Columbus in the Value City Arena. Right point Harvey. Feeds inside. Nice give and go. Locks it off the pick. Found it wide open to the right block and scored. Has a dozen.
Well, give and go, but they also had an up screen for her as well that opened things up and the basket wide open.
Miller a 3, left side Ohio State. Short, 1 and done. Ferreira the rebound, USF. 4:04 to play in the third. It's 52-30 Bulls, and we're going to get a hard collision at the baseline. And an Ohio State foul is going to be called on Nasha Quinlan. Her first. 5th on Ohio State. Free throws coming up, but after our third quarter media timeout. And Quinlan on the floor. Free throw coming up for Laura Ferreira, the senior forward from Portugal, fifth-year senior. Free throw up and in, her 7th point. USF is now 18 for 22 from the free throw line. 18 of their 53 points. Second one, airborne and in. 8 for Ferreira. 4 to play in the third. The deficit for the Buckeyes is 24, 54-30. USF won last year 84-65 in Tampa, and they're trying to sweep this home at home here in Columbus the following year. Miller around the horn for Santoro, on the drive into the lane, right hand runner up and in. Carly Santoro, she's shown a pretty good move taking it in from the right side. Tony,
well, she can get to the rim, and that time she was able to create just enough space to be able to get that shot off. Had some issues a little bit in the first half, but doing a nice job of coming back at it here.
54-32 Bulls with under 3.5 to play in the third. At the left wing, Harvey, and we're going to whistle off the ball and an offensive foul. I think you're going to get Kitty Alaksa for the player control foul, team control foul away from the ball. Alaksa's first foul. That turnover for USF, number 10. Buckeyes have turned it over 9 times, yet Ohio State the ball down 54-32 with 3:15 left in the third. Patty handles out front, throws for Santoro, left point. Top of the key for Quinlan, who works to the right, looking for a back cutter. Instead, out front for Patty. Aaliyah Patty passes for Carly Santoro. Again on the drive to the goal from the low right. No good. Hit the floor, but fouled. And he'll be back to the stripe to throw 2 more. Foul went on Leverett, her 2nd. Again, that top of the key to the right drive. Right-hand layup dry, and Santoro's going to draw free throws out of it.
Absolutely. You know, and again, Matt, we talked about it at halftime, what Ohio State needed to do, and they're doing it. They're trying to get to the rim. They're trying to get to the glass.
Santoro's first free throw no good off the back iron. Carly, a year ago at Bowling Green, 67% from the stripe. Her degree in communication disorders, grad transfer from BG, and that free throw good, her 12th point in her Buckeyes debut. 3 minutes to play in the third, 54-33. The Bulls have the lead, and they have the ball. Harvey on the baseline, drives from the right side. missed a layup try. Scrum for the rebound. It's loose, taken by Henshaw, and USF will recycle. Fresh shot clock as Harvey gets it out front. We've got a technical foul called on Carmen Grande. I don't know what.
She said something.
She must have said the magic word.
Yeah.
Or words. Grande called for the technical foul. That'll be her fourth personal.
I think she was wanting a foul.
Loxa, free throw number one of the technical miss. And Loxa again, by the way. And that was good. Now 3 of 4 Loxa from the line, but that miss of a free throw, she missed all of 6 a year ago. And again,
crazy.
Led America
yep.
at 97%.
She just lost her focus enough.
13 for Loxa with 1 of 2, and USF retains the ball. Side left, Henshaw. Throws it right point, Harvey. Harvey off the pick. Now for Loxa, who ran down a wild pass to the right corner. Queenland guards her. Loxa put the ball on her hip. There's no turnover called. Instead, it'll go out front for Harvey. 18 to shoot. 2.5 to play in the third. 55-33 USF. Harvey off the pick right. Harvey throws out front for Henshaw, who dumps it inside and tipped out of bounds by Ohio State's Patty. 8 to shoot, and USF will handle the ball to the baseline left.
Patty did a nice job of going over top on that on the pass and was able to get a nice deflection. 8 seconds on the shot clock.
Locks it with inbound, throws it into the left corner and gets it back, and then we're going to get a whistle and a foul.
Oh, you've got Queenland that was really fighting her way to try and get through that screen.
Second foul on Queenland. Coach McGuff didn't like the call, but for the third time in 3 quarters, USF is in the penalty, and this time with 2:22 to play in the period. Loxa for 2 more. First one, good. 14 for Loxa. That was the thing I recall about last year in that game when Ohio State made a little bit of a run. She stepped to the line and just drained free throws. Loxa 1 year ago set a USF single season scoring record with 717 points. And now needs about 660 this year to become the all-time leading scorer at USF, surpassing Jessica Dixon's 2402 set between 03 to 07. Loxa hits both free throws and has 15 points, and now we're going to get a whistle off the ball and a USF foul call with 2:12 left in the third.
Yeah, it's going to be a hold. You can't impede the progress of a cutter.
Fallon Ferreira, her third all this quarter. And Santoro to our left for 2 shots. Carly has 7 points this period, and she's back to the stripe. Both teams in the bonus. First free throw for Santoro up and in for her 13th point of the game.
Well, Santoro's done a nice job. And again, she just adjusts so well.
Mm-hmm. Second one short. Ball tipped around and taken on the board by Loxa. So 1 of 2 for Santoro, the grad student from Bellevue, Ohio. Loxa drives, pitches to Penzon for a near corner 3. It's strong, no good. Kidia Loxa gets a rebound. 57-34 Bulls, under 2 to play. Still in the third quarter. Leverett at the right wing near side for the Bulls. Throws it out front for Henshaw. Squares up, gives it back right wing. Illegal screen on a check play by Leverett at the right block. Leverett called for a third foul. Player control foul.
I got to tell you, though, their screens as well as anybody that I've seen in a long time. They happen to get called for an illegal screen right there, but throughout the game, they just really utilize the screens well. They set them well, and they screen it and utilize the screen well.
Buckeyes have hit 5 of their last 6 field goals. They get the ball inside to Patty. She's double-teamed, gives it over to Queenland at the right corner. Re-enters Patty. Spin move, laid it in nicely down with the left hand. From the right block, Aaliyah Patty with a good-looking play.
Now, what I like is the fact you had some inside-outside action, but then they come right back inside the post. Well done.
57-36, the Bulls. A minute 14 to play in the third. Loxa, left wing forecourt for USF. Out front for Henshaw. Works right, gives it right for Penzon. Drives to the right block, double dribbled, but no call. Ball loose, held ball, arrow, Ohio State. This is what we're going to see. If this team struggles this year, you're not going to see the fight give. I've already believed that with all of the veteran presence they have, Tony.
Absolutely.
Minute, I know that's a little consolation when you win and lose, but they're giving. see one let up, though, on both ends.
Not quitting at all. Nope. That's a great point, Matt.
Right to left. Here comes Grande, Ohio State, to Santoro at the left wing. Off the screen to the top and out of the foul line. Stops, bounce pass right corner. She short-armed it into the corner, intended for Miller, and it went on out of bounds off her hands. Yeah, turnover number 10.
She tried to make that one-handed pass because she wasn't able to secure it with two and didn't have the control.
Yeah, the Buckeyes had five turnovers after one quarter. That's just 10 in the game. 43 seconds left in the third. 57-36 USF the lead. They've got The Rock with Penzon at the right wing. Down the right wing for Loxa. Little handoff. She's guarded and bodied up by Grande. Step back jumper. No good. Rebound Grande on the fly. 2-on-2. Grande up the right wing. Carmen Grande for Ohio State. Baseline drive under the bucket. Throws it across Miller. Fumbles it. Left point. And Quinlan couldn't get the shot away. Drops it for the foul line. Patty with a catch. And Patty with a walk as she put it down late after taking steps. Turnover gives it to the Bulls.
Yeah, again, footwork is everything. You've got your little jab and go, jab and shoot, jab and cross. And you have to know what your feet are doing, where the defender is.
13 seconds left in the third. Bulls will play for the last shot. Penzon at the point to the high left. Bounce pass. Top of the key. Loxa. Five to go. Hand check. Miller. Check that. Quinlan. I'm sorry. It was 23, not 15. Quinlan on the hand check. And that's going to put Kitty and Loxa at the line for some easy points.
Now, you know, here's the thing. The officials have been consistent the whole game. As a defender, you have to make the adjustment.
Loxa, honorable mention, All-American each of the last 2 years. Preseason All-American pick this year. First free throw good. First team All-Conference selection in the American Conference this year, and was the American Freshman of the Year in 15-16. 16 points on that free throw. Second one for Loxa. 5.5 seconds left. Free throw good, her 17th point. 5 seconds to go. Buckeyes to go the length of the floor. Down 59-36. Grande into front court. 2-1. High on the right. Didn't get a shot off. Gotta know the clock there. End of three. 59-36. USF the lead quarter. Ohio State with the lineup of Crooms, Grande, Waterman, Quinlan, and Juhas.
Now, Matt, here's an interesting thing. You know, Ohio State has 11 turnovers. South Florida has 13 turnovers. But USF has only scored 8 points off of Ohio State's turnovers, and Ohio State has only scored 6 points off the turnovers. So neither team is really converting off of opportunities.
Penzon at the top for USF. Shot clock 13. Works to the right wing. Moving left to right, fourth quarter, USF. Penzon with a step back three from 22. No good. Good contest by Waterman. Rebound comes down to Miller. Buckeyes running right to left. Half minute gone to the fourth, trailing by 23. Crooms has it right wing. Right corner will go for Miller. Quinlan drops it inside for Juhas. Bounce pass Waterman. Down the key. Fouled. Going to the bucket from left to the rim. And she took it in strong and drew the foul.
Now, I like the fact that Ohio State's going inside. And they tried to get the low block into Juhas. And then you had a nice basket cut by Waterman.
That foul is called on Yanetta Rosenthala. Freshman from Latvia who gets her first action. That's her first foul, and it comes 40 seconds into the fourth quarter. Waterman's troubles have been her whole career from the foul line, frankly, and she misses another one there. She is 2 of 5 in this game from the stripe. Last year shot at just 58% from there. She bricks that one, missing both of them. The rebound comes down to Loxa of USF. Nearly a minute gone in the fourth, 59-36. The Bulls the lead in the Rock. Penzon at the right point. Buckeyes man-to-man. Bounce pass goes off the left side. Pahadzic. Pahadzic on the drive. End of the lane with a right-hand runner and scored. Anna Pahadzic, the sophomore from Denmark, with her first points as a Bull. And on the drive right of the key, Ohio State's Janae Crooms will draw the foul. In the shot motion. And the foul is called on Penzon. That'll be her first.
Buckeyes have the advantage is inside the paint throughout scoring. USF 22-18, so they're doing a nice job of, you know, looking at and attacking the interior.
Janae Crooms to our left for two shots. The first one's missed. She had a field goal in the third quarter. A four-star guard and top 40 in last year's class out of St. Andrews High School in Cranston, Rhode Island. Janae Crooms, second one, line drives it in. It's her third point. 8:50 to play.
Ohio State struggling from the line. At least now they've got to the line 15 times, but they're only shooting 47%.
They're 2 of 16 from deep. Nothing since the first quarter, and just shooting 33% for the game from the floor. But Hasich in the right corner misfires a three. The board off to Santoro, the Buckeyes. Carly on the foul line drive. Now to Waterman, who curls right of the key, throws it across, and threw it away. Pass to the corner intended for Quinlan, and bringing the ball up the floor. But Hasich for USF fouled hard on the drive. It's going to go on Waterman. That's her fourth.
As an offensive player, you have to make sure that when you're off the ball, you are creating a gap. You're creating a seam for your teammates to pass the ball. And Ohio State in that possession was lined up even with the defenders, so Waterman didn't have any pass to anybody, therefore resulting in a turnover.
There's a discrepancy here on the foul call. Angie Inland called the foul on Waterman. It looked like the foul should have been on Miller. Angie says it was Waterman. Dickerson corrects her and changes the foul to Quinlan. So not Waterman's fourth, and Waterman's going to go right back in the game. I didn't think she was near the ball when it was called, but Jesse Dickerson overrules and says it's on 23, Quinlan her fourth. So whoever it's on, it's their fourth. And they changed it to Quinlan's foul. 61-37 USF. Bulls the ball at the left corner. Podhajic off the screen, gives it to the left sideline, Rosenthal. Now back to Podhajic. Feeds it in at the left block for Raider. Backs down Santoro for to shoot. Sweeps in and nicely done. Scored with a right hand, Alyssa Raider.
Now you have the size inside, and she just was able to go right at Santoro.
Yeah. 63-37, South Florida. That guy's playing an American Conference team here tonight. They're going to get UConn, an American Conference team, Sunday up at Stores. Step back, long two Crooms. Heel to the rim, top of the backboard, no good. Rebound, flat-footed Raider, who boxed out Dorka Juhasz. Now for Pinzon, who front courts. 7.5 to go in the game. 63-37 USF. Off the screen right, locks it down the lane. Right-hand layup, try miss. Rebound, Dorka. She'll dribble up the floor right to left. Takes it into front court. Stops, gives for Santoro trailing. Carly on the drive, low on the right. Scoops it up, no good. Whistle on a foul called on USF.
Now she did a nice job of splitting the defenders. Setting it up, little hesitation. Had a little seam to get to the rim.
Fallon Loxa, that's her second. Free throws for Carly Santoro. This has certainly been a bright spot in the second half, the way Santoro's gotten to the rim.
No, absolutely. But again, you know how Ohio State has been attacking. They've been trying to, you know, you had Juhasz that was putting the ball on the floor, also looking at feeding her inside in the post. You've got Waterman that had some nice basket cuts.
Free throw miss. Well, Ohio State at 7 of 16 from the free throw line, 44%. They struggle to score as it is, and when they get to the line, they simply have to be better from the stripe.
You know, free throws are two things. One is technique, but the other is flat-out concentration. And if you're not shooting to score, you will absolutely miss the shot. It's very different than coming in for a jumper, coming in off of a pick, or a three-point shot. All your free throws are technique and concentration.
Santoro hits the free throw, has 14. She checks out. Waterman back in. 7 minutes left to go in the game. A three from the high left. Misfired there by Rosenthal. And it's out of bounds after the ball comes loose and nobody touched it. Buckeyes will get it.
Now, Ohio State dodged one right there, because I will tell you, they did not box her out and she was not able to secure it. And otherwise, you were looking at a putback.
Crooms on the drive to Waterman and now to Quinlan at the right point. Head of the wheel, it'll come now for Crooms. She'll dribble into the lane, have it knocked away, goes to the floor, and a held ball arrow to keep it with Ohio State. Janae Crooms with a take there.
Now that's a situation where the ball just needed to be reversed. You need a little bit more ball movement. It was well defended. Just get the pass, work the pass. You get the ball reversal, then you can look to attack a seam or get to the rim.
Buckeye ball with 15 to shoot. Dorka gets the inbounds. A little reverse up and under layup from the left side. No good. Rebound out of bounds. And as Miller hits the deck, knocking over a photographer, the ball will be off of Buckeye and go to USF. 6:40 left to go in the game. The Bulls 63, the Buckeyes 38. Ohio State's season low a year ago was 60 points at Duke. They've got a lot of work to do if they're going to avoid that kind of number here tonight. Misfired three from the top left, thrown up by Michaela Kessner, who checks in for the first time. Ohio State with a rebound, Janae Crooms. She's in front court at the near left point, off the pick to the foul line, stops, throws it across right wing, angling in, Miller to the bucket, lost it, fumbled it away, out of bounds, off of a Bull. And I think it went off Raider. It'll stay with Ohio State with 12 on the shot clock.
Well, let's see what Ohio State does with this. This is an opportunity for them to try and get a quick score. I like inbounds plays when you're running a play to score, not just inbound the ball.
Patty releases Dorke Juhas. Buckeyes get the inbounds pass for Crooms. Throws it right wing, Miller. Steps into a three. Got it. That's the first three since the first quarter for the Buckeyes. And that's Adriana Miller, the grad transfer from LaSalle, hitting that triple. She had 62 threes a year ago while at LaSalle. And that three pulls the Buckeyes within 22. And we get a tie-up on the drive in. Good job there by Juhas to reach in and tie up Rosentana, and the arrow will keep it with the Bulls.
Ohio State defended that extremely well.
63-41 USF. 5:48 to go in the game. They've got the ball to the baseline right with 18 to shoot. Ball looped down to the right point. Ferreira with the dribble top of the key on Quinlan. Gives it back now. Harvey, I think, handling. You can't see the numbers or the name with the long hair. It's Harvey. She drives, throws it away. Steal by Waterman, Ohio State. Michaela dribbling up the floor. Ahead now for Crooms. Crooms left corner. Set three. Quinlan airballed strong. Rebound Miller. Buckeyes under the bucket. Still fighting for the loose ball. Tie up. Hands into the cookie jar. And the alternating arrow on the help ball gives it to the Buckeyes.
Now Miller really had to fight for that one. Ohio State trying to score. Or shoot a three-pointer coming out of transition. Not a great look, but at least Miller being aggressive on the inside.
Inbounds pass for Buckeyes Patty, and now she'll get for Waterman. Leaves it off the right wing. Crooms off the dribble drive. Stops, throws it near left corner. Miller will drive to the low left, up and under, no good. Rebound, Miller back up, no, but a foul as Adriana Miller goes crashing to glass.
Yeah, that's just great effort right there. Good baseline attack. She misses her shot, gets the rebound. Good second opportunity there.
Miller shooting two to our left. 81% free thrower a year ago at LaSalle, and that free throw is perfect. Her fourth point all in this quarter for the Buckeyes. But Adich is back in for USF. Michaela Kessner goes to the bench. The second one good for Miller, who rattled it down. Adriana Miller, who drew the start here tonight, has five on that free throw. 63-45 USF. 5:02 to play in the game. Bulls the ball at the left point. A three-point shot by Raider flung up and missed. Offensive board for Ferreira. She'll spin out to the corner, and now slow and reset for Harvey. 4:50 left to go in the game. 63-43 USF. Coach Fernandez calls the play from across the way for USF. Plays it off for Pahadzic at the left point. Left wing, it'll go Ferreira. Shoots a three. Standstill, triple try over Quinlan. No. Rebound. Buckeyes, Patty. Leaves it off for Crooms. Her front court's up the right point. Now off the screen. On the gallop to the bucket. And had it taken away. Trying to throw a pass across court. Raider a steal. Now Waterman comes, gets a loose ball, and gets a timeout called. Down by 20, but the grad senior Waterman going after the loose ball. Buckeyes have played pretty good defense. Ball looped out front for Waterman. She's got it in front court, top of the key. Starts down the key left side, plays it out left wing for Miller, who circles with the paint. Shoots one up from the low right, missed it from short range. Loose ball, Waterman on the floor, Miller to the floor. Held ball, arrow to USF.
Now, once again, Waterman getting on the floor.
Great effort.
Yep, she has those pads on her knees and not afraid to get in there and mix it up.
4:10, 4:09 for the game. 63-43, Bulls the lead in the Rock. Harvey left to right in the front court, slows and leaves it off the right wing for Ferreira. puts it down once to Rader between the rings. Alyssa Rader back to Ferreira at the right wing. Buckeyes look like they're in almost a diamond and one with the chaser on Loxa. And on the scoop shot on the drive into the middle of the lane. Shot missed there by Ferreira. Rebound comes out. A fresh shot clock for the Bulls. And Harvey's going to recycle back near center circle. Crooms picks her up. Harvey starts to drive right, throws it left instead for Ferreira. There's the baseline jumper up and good. And that one's good by Beatrice. She has 11 of double figures. 65-43, South Florida the lead. 3:20 left to go. Buckeyes handle it. Quinlan, top of the key with a left-hand dribble and off the curl. Fouled by Harvey. It'll be her second personal foul. That is a floor violation.
State utilizing the pick on the ball very nicely. And that's the thing. You've got to come off shoulder to shoulder, whether that it be a screen or a pick. And, you know, when you the pick happens when you have the ball, you've got to be able to come off shoulder to shoulder on that.
That was the fifth, not the 14th foul, beg your pardon. So Quinlan, free throw line left to shoot two, and Naja nails that one. Transfer from Pacific, as mentioned, a graduate guard from Sacramento, California, and she averaged 5 points and four boards in 84 games in her career at Pacific and 39 starts. She hit both free throws. Naja Quinlan has four in the game, and it's 65-45 USF. 3:12 left to go. Ferreira, right wing, right corner, Harvey. 3-point shots on air ball. Missed it strong and left. Rebound into the hands of Ohio State's Quinlan, who drives to the foul line, sealed off right wing for a 3-point shot fake by Patty, and then on the step in she traveled. And the Buckeyes turn it over for a 13th time, but USF has turned it over 15.
Now again, off that shot fake, you have to take that step off that fake and then step with the same foot, and that's what happens. You fake with one foot, step with the other, it's a travel.
2:50 to go in the game, 65-45 USF. Harvey out front, now left side for Ferreira. Left corner to go for Alyssa Rader. Back to Ferreira at the head of the wheel. 12 to shoot. Dribbles once, throws it on top for Harvey. Bounces it right of the lane. Caught there by Jordan, and she'll bank it in right of the square.
Yeah, Ohio State just a little too late getting out there and trying to get the angle on the entry feed down inside the post. Ohio State last three possessions have been in a zone defense.
Beatrice Jordan with 13 on that lay-in. 2:20 left at 67-45 USF. Quinlan on the drive, down the lane right side, got bumped, no call, and still sticks it in right of the rim on a layup runner.
Now, good body control there by Quinlan and using the glass.
Six for Quinlan, and with 2:06 to go at 67-47 USF. Ferreira, left wing, bounce pass, left corner, Harvey, back to Ferreira at the left point. Crosses over, moves into the lane, hands for Rader, goes to the bucket, may have had her shot blocked and swatted away by Patty, and it's knocked out of bounds to stay with the Bulls on the baseline with 13 in the shot clock.
I do have to say, I did like that move there by Ferreira. She comes in and has a little stutter step hesitation, crossover, kept the ball down low, but good hands by the Buckeyes.
Dorky Juhas for Michaela Waterman. In fact, the Buckeyes, the number of subs, Carly Santoro and Carmen Grande are back in. 1:54 left. It's 67-47 USF. Ball put in and tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Ohio State's Grande as she tried to knock it away from Loxa. 12 on the shot clock. Less than 2 minutes to play in the game. Ferreira in for Loxa, deep right corner. Back to Ferreira at the foul line. Down the lane, left-hand runner, no good. Tip, no. Corralled by Jordan, put it back in right in the middle of the lane.
Now you have the inside position. That's where you have to secure the ball. That's just great effort. Sorry, Matt. Nope. Great effort by USF, but Ohio State had the inside position.
Minute 33 left. 69-47 Bulls. Ohio State's Patty giving go Grande to the bucket with a left-hand layup. Try, missed it. Rader the rebound. Bulls the ball and Harvey. 1:20 to play. Harvey in forward court at the left point, throws it inside, knocked away and stolen. Good reach around by Patty. Aaliyah Patty deflects it away, and Grande retreats for Ohio State. She'll drive to the bucket, throw it across for Santoro. Out left wing, handled by Crooms. Baseline drive at the left block, put it up, no good. Got her own rebound, had it knocked away. Minute to play. Dribbling up the floor at the forward court at the left point for Rader. She'll slow. Back near midcourt. Harvey has it. Harvey working to the left hash. Throws out front for Kitty Alaksa. Drops it mid-post right side. Spinning Jordan out of the bucket again with a left hand. Boy, that is smooth. Freshman from Portugal at 17.
Yep, it certainly was. And she just turned right over that right shoulder, finished with the left hand.
Grande, Ohio State, 36 seconds left. Santoro with the ball out front. Carly Santoro at the foul line. Now out front for a three put up by Patty. No good. Wide right. Shot clock's off as the rebound comes down to Ferreira. 25 seconds left in the game. Jose Fernandez says, keep it out there. Now 20 seconds left. South Florida is going to sweep the home at home. They're going to come to Columbus and win on opening night. Ohio State on the short end of the season opener to the USF Bulls, the 22nd ranked team in the country, with an emphatic win. There's the final 3 seconds.